Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, friends. Welcome back to my channel. I have this Panasonic fax machine power supply. It is not turning on the machine. Let's see what is the problem here. If you don't have good practical experience in power electronics, never try to repair. I will apply input line voltage. It is 220 volts. We can go to internet and we can go to the part number which is mentioned here. Search from Google, you can find its service manual. I downloaded the circuit diagram here as well. Let's power on. The lamp turned on and then it returned back to normal condition. That means the power supply is giving response, it is turning on. But now we will see what is the condition. Never touch this primary area. It is live circuit. Set multimeter to DC voltage. If we check voltage at a rectifier, we can see this rectifier is fluctuating from 2.5 volts. And if we check this one, it have in millivolts. This circuit, it have good sign that 2.5 volt because it is 5 volt section, and this one it is 24 volt section that is reaching here. It is in millivolts. That means this section have problem because it is two section power supply. Now if I will check main DC capacitor, it is fluctuating badly. And if we check VCC capacitor that is connected to VCC pin of the IC, this capacitor C109, we can see when this capacitor fluctuates badly, and we check the voltage on drain to source DC voltage, we can see it has fluctuation. That means the IC is in restart mode because the VCC pin that is fluctuating badly. Yes. So it is indicating that there is short circuit in the secondary. Here we have primary winding and snubber circuit, this MOSFET, it is switching. And this is our auxiliary winding at pin number 6. It have fluctuation, it is using KA7552 IC. So that means the voltage are increasing at full. Here we have around 2.5 volt fluctuation at this IC202. It is 5 volt section. And this section, it is dropping all the voltage and the feedback network is also here. Voltage reference, the LED of the optocoupler that are here. Optocoupler second portion is here. That means this section have problem. Either the IC is bad, rectifier IC, full wave rectifier is bad, or maybe capacitor or any component. Let's see. I remove the power. Now if we check this capacitor, its top surface is raised up. That is indicating that this capacitor is overheat. If we see this one, it is plain. But if we touch the top surface here, it is raised upside. So we need to check this capacitor. That is here, C201. First we need to remove and check it. Capacitance, it is not measuring any capacitance. If you check the continuity, it is short circuit. So this capacitor have internal short circuit. So this capacitor is 470 microfarad, 35 volts. And I have this 470, 35 volts. It is a battery charger circuit for drill machine. We'll check the condition. When you are testing the capacitor, always discharge it properly. Yeah, that's good. 479. That's good. Let's install it. When you are connecting the capacitor, always take care for the polarity. This side is negative side. And here is also mentioned on the board, negative mark. Negative polarity sign. Now I connected the capacitor, negative this side, positive this side. Let's power it on. DC voltage. You can check here. Yes, that's great. This time the 24 volt section is now powered on. And 5 volt section. That's also exact 5 volts. The design is really excellent. It is using KA7552 IC. Now we can check the VCC capacitor here. You can see it is perfect. Now it is stable. Check voltage at main DC capacitor. It is 336 volts. That's good. Check DC voltage from drain to source. Here we have drain and source. So it is blocking voltage. That's good. 359 volt, because the capacitor supply, that is 336 volt. When the voltage stress is increased, then the capacitor voltage 358 volt. Why? Because this capacitor, it is 334 volt. When the IC will switch, when the MOSFET will switch, it will allow negative ground side to couple to the winding, because it is connected in the ground side. Positive supply is already applied. When the MOSFET will turn off, it will close this ground side and magnetic field will collapse. When it will turn off, it will open this ground connection. When it is open, at that time the magnetic field here will collapse. When it will collapse, it will create a reverse voltage to the applied voltage. So this reverse polarity voltage will cause to build here double stress from ground, from source to drain. But that time this snapper circuit will discharge that extra voltage, and some voltage out of that reverse voltage will remain here. That is causing, it is creating stress here. So that is the reason we are taking some extra voltage at this drain to source. This is 358 volt. It is around, it is around, we can say 15, 16 volt, up to 30 volt. If it is available, this stress is available, no problem. That means the IC is switching. So it is also a way to test the switching. If the voltage at drain to source are more than the supply voltage, that will be a sign that IC is switching. If the voltage here at capacitor are stable, that means the IC is switching smoothly. The feedback network is working. Our this optocoupler output side, it is 909 millivolt. And if we check input side, it is 1 volt, 1.06 volt. If we check the output rectifier, it is 24.5 volt. And supply at capacitor voltage, it is 24.42 volt. That is here at output terminal. I hope you enjoyed this video. If it is good, hit the like button. If you have any question, write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.